And I'll just read through these few here. The dissipation of grammar and how to deal with truth being revealed. This is just from today, really, but it's also applies to the whole conference. Opening to new perspectives and views. Yes, big time for all of us. The shifting energies from unipolar to multipolar. The new finance and economy. The shifting from conflict to harmony. Existing schisms or contradictions. And healing divisions. And these are a few dialogue, discussion, talking points that we can start with and or add to. The second part two session, which is after the break, after the dinner and lunch, 1 hour break, will be brainstorming future possibilities. So in this first session, we harvest the essential gems, as Uta referred to them as. And we acknowledge those things, but of course there are, as I said to her a couple of hours ago, there's also the lumps of coal that haven't been transformed into gems or diamonds yet. And they must be obviously acknowledged too, such as the existing schisms, contradictions, divisions, conflicts, etc., etc. So I open it to the floor, so to speak, or maybe back to you, Uta, for commentary before we proceed.
I would just ask. Of course, it's. Here we go. I would like to suggest that we all put our cameras on, or at least those who are comfortable with it, so we can have a bit of a human element now at the end of our conference and in our sharing. Don't know if you can see me at all with this. There's a strong sun coming through my jalousie. But anyway,
sun is always good.
Yes, your polka dot sun decoration there, Uta.
Yeah. Well, it fits your decoration behind you, Philip. Actually.
Yeah. Don't tell us that you didn't prepare that.
So great to see all your faces, and I think this can also engender some more spontaneous communication. I would just lay down a couple of points before we start. Please keep your comments succinct, 1 to 2 minutes. Try not to ramble on, as some of us can tend to do, as when we are connecting the dots in our mind as we're talking. So and allow, of course, be aware of the fact that we're sharing quite a few people here, and we have about 40 minutes to do so fairly comfortably, I think. So just to mention that.
So we can just highlight, throw into the circle, what are the gems, what is for us very precious of this conference, what do we take with us for further holding precious and continuing to develop.
Or address any of those points that I just posted, which is just a start, really. It's not to complete by any means. I'm going to post that in the chat actually as well, for easy reference.
I can share that I think we could agree that there's been a great orb of light and consciousness and will to good created in this conference that is quite radiant and very much planted as a seed, I think, in the etheric body of humanity. And I think if we can continue the dialogue, continue the relationship, because at this level, there is no division. We're on the same path to discover how to dissolve the outer material, really, barriers. When I say material, it includes the lower mind. You know, the threefold lower world is material. that divides us from this sublime, truly sublime unity, oneness. And how do we bring that down into the three lower worlds? How do we cleanse the substance that's old and divided? How do we flush it out so that the Christ has a clear etheric body to descend into after 2025, and that we are a part of it? And I shared on the Telegram a passage from Esoteric Psychology, Volume 2, I invite you to look at. We have a big destiny ahead of us on this beautiful blue globe that leads all the way to the heart of the one about whom naught may be said. I want us to today embrace the vision of that destiny and work together to be on that path.
Your statement, Deborah, connects with something that came through in my meditation this morning, and that being that as agents of planetary change, we have to remember that the goal that we are directed to or are looking to is to assist in making this planet sacred. Okay. It's that process of redeeming the substance so that this planet can become sacred. And as such, you know, we're all rolling up our sleeves, you know, and doing the work. So, and in that process, there is automatic unification. You know, you come together to do that, which means that we're not looking at the differences any longer. We're looking at where everything is unified and how it can, and what to do to make it unified, which is way more important than differences.
Thank you, Deborah and Loretta. Anyone else like to chime in as we ring these bells, so to speak? Sorry for the crude metaphor. And I can see faces from all over the world here, in Europe, USA. Extraordinary.
Let me step in, perhaps, to really express my joy at seeing you all as really a group consciousness, a group life emerging from out of such diversity. And yes, each of us, it has been something of a struggle to meet at this frequency on the alignment to Aries, which, as Philip mentioned, is first ray, but channeling the cosmic second ray through Jupiter, what an extraordinary moment for us to share. And I'm deeply touched by hearing your beautiful words, Sveta, Dennis, your own language. Listening to your words was like music. You spoke of symphonies of nations. And this is so heartening that it melts the barriers like ice returning to its liquid state. Truly a medicine of the heart. And I extend my love and brotherhood to you, your people, and so to all of us, our humanity. Thank you.
Я расскажу немножко по-русски. Саша, поможешь?
Да, сейчас, секундочку. Mikhail, I would have to translate, and it would be easier for me to translate simultaneously in the booth if you could activate it.
Okay, one sec.
Сейчас Михаил включит переводческую.
Я могу тогда говорить без задержки? Не слышу.
Да, да.
Okay, just to let everyone know in here right now, Alexander is now in the translation booth and Dennis will speak in Russian. So go to the button interpretation, click it and choose English. You'll be able to hear the translated language.
Mm-hmm. Возможно, я повторюсь, но сначала я хотел бы поблагодарить Джонатана за теплые слова любви. И я хотел сказать также о том, что мы с Джонатаном тоже уже давно знакомы и проводили совместные медитации. И мы очень ценим ту работу, которую он проводит по стимуляции треугольника трех великих наций. Это действительно работа, которая очень важна сегодня для восстановления циркуляции этих энергий. А сегодняшняя конференция, возможно, даст нам новые понимания, что же мешает, реально мешает циркуляции этих энергий и что должно быть исправлено. Еще раз, Джонатан, спасибо. Я, возможно, еще раз повторюсь, но для нас эта конференция явилась такой очень могущественная точка напряжения. Она действительно мы видели и на себе ощущали эти энергии напряжения, группового напряжения. А за напряжением следует кризис и выход. Таким образом, эта конференция осаждает в хорошем понимании кризис, после которого будет обязательно точка выхода и расширения И я вижу эту конференцию как новый полюс в западном мире, и не только в западном, конечно, и в России, но представлены на Западе, который даст какой-то новый толчок, новую жизнь, новым энергии. И это, конечно, очень хорошо. И большое спасибо организаторам за и Филиппу отдельно за эту смелость, за то, что все-таки эта конференция была сделана, причем на высшем уровне. И большое спасибо Михаэлю, потому что это тоже техническая сторона была просто безупречна.
Barclay, did you want to talk? No, just a thumb up. Okay.
I can read the two chats. This conference from Mary Christina, Maria Christina Donadieu. This conference was as if a presentation and celebration of a newborn baby. May it be a harbinger of the harmony of the fast approaching fourth ray.
My synthesis of this conference is as follows. It was asserted that oneness is and unity must be created. So my reflection was how to create this unity, what is really unity? And the answer from this conference I got is that unity is not homologation. It's not to agree with other points of view. If your consciousness says different, unity is must be hierarchical, and hierarchy is a coordinated cooperation towards a goal. So are we able to be this coordinated cooperation towards the same goal? Maybe yes, for some points. Maybe not for other points. So meanwhile, we have this model of hierarchy that is seen from different points, like the elephant. Everyone has this concept of hierarchy. To me, this unity we try to create also through this conference for now in towards this model of cooperated, coordinated cooperation toward the same goal is to be in a safe space, listening, fostering or getting our discrimination better, and definitely watch what our consciousness is saying every moment. And so to me, maybe it's my Italian nation characteristic is to be occultist is to be heretic. And I think hierarchy is a group, an order of heretics, of free spirits. And that is really something higher or more central than to build a group. Is really to build an order. So my vision and mission in this incarnation is to show this necessity for the Aquarian Age to build an order, a system of functions in the new group of world servers. Up to now, in the higher mental level, as an ideal, and that's precisely what we have been doing for the last 40 years with my group or system, harmonic system. So I think that every nation has this treasure to give to the world, to understand what is its function in the system and to give the best of it, to build this hierarchical humanity. That's my answer to create this unity for the future, for the Aquarian Age. So thanks to also to this conference, which is an attempt to create a sort of unity. And thanks especially to Michael and Philip and Alexander, which is doing a great job in translating. Thank you to all presenters and the participants.
Thank you, Antonella. And this theme of unity in diversity, the real key factor that you mentioned. Thank you.
I would like to just share one brief quote that's so apt for this moment, I think, from Applied Wisdom Master R, who says the divine purpose of humanity is to create the forms through which the consciousness of God can manifest.
And can we hear now from others who have not spoken yet?
John has raised his hand.
Okay, John. Go ahead, John. Not sure if the volume's working.
You're muted.
Yes, thank you. Well, I've experienced from these days here a change of atmosphere. a lifting of a fog that surrounds humanity. Through us, I feel this atmospheric change. And the word atmosphere also has the word fear at the end, F-E-A-R. And the first part of that word is atmos, which connects to atma. So I'm thinking that all this comes about by speaking, a lifting of fear is the courage to speak from the heart. And as everyone speaks from the heart, the atmospheric change is felt, is powerful. And the lungs surround the heart. I've often thought like wings. And when fear is lifted, we can breathe in and breathe out. And I think that the goal here is to help the human race open its wings again. Heart, soul, love, and the courage to speak from that center. This is a group that has immense knowledge, and a strong head center is operating. But it seems so, it's like a refreshing wind, a breeze, an uplift when that shifts to the heart level. If we can train ourselves at this to be a continuous state between head and heart, and that opening of the lungs, that expansion, that change of atmosphere will work its own magic. And the words we speak will penetrate human consciousness, because we've created an atmosphere of trust. And then the words of truth will come back. Truth has been exchanged for opinion now. What used to be called opinion is now called my truth, your truth. And how to get back to that one state of truth. But I'm over speaking it now. And so I just wanted to get back to that idea of an atmosphere of love. It feels like beauty. It has inspiration in it, and it has liberation in it. And thank you all. That's all for now.
Thank you for your beautiful wisdom there, John. We have 15 minutes left for those who haven't spoken yet to contribute. So,
Barclay?
Mm-hmm. No, he's clapping. I don't think he has his hand.
Oh, it's a clapping.
Well, I haven't had a lot of opportunity to attend many of these talks. In fact, very few due to matters here at the house, but I do intend to listen to all of them over the next week or so. The old way of doing science and technology was to get a group of people together with a like purpose in mind and to throw everything out on the table. No idea was too strange or too stupid or too bright. No, everything was put together and a synthesis came out of that. And that's essentially what we've done here. My sense and my inner sense of what this conference has accomplished is a clearing of the air, as has been mentioned, a budding synthesis, the ability to express without being sidelined or put down or criticized. These are all important. We have a lot of work to do, each in our own way, in the coming years, as we close out this period of the forerunner. And, you know, we're going to see great changes over the next couple of decades, especially as Pluto goes through Aquarius. Ideas are going to be changing. They're going to be coming quick and fast. The world is going to be changed within a few short years. One of the things that's going to become most important over the next immediate years ahead is the need for healing, especially through the West. The East is taking care of itself. This is something to be mindful of and to address the immediate need as it comes up. So the more we can share our diverse views and to remain non-critical, yet discriminating, the more of service we'll be and to hold the meditative point in the center, away from all the swirling masses of data, information, opinions, whatever we have in front of us. So I give thanks for all the presenters, all the technical support for this conference, and I look forward to further dialogue with all of you.
Thank you, Malvin. And your light was, for me, was especially bright and brings everything into fifth ray order. So I'm very grateful for this.
I read Christina. Did anyone read the Marie Christina's comment?
I started to, okay. But you want me to go through the chat again?
Just if we didn't read out Marie Christina's comment, did we do that or not? I can't remember.
I did. It was right before Antonella.
Okay, very good.
And now Grete has raised her hand.
Yeah. I want to express my deep gratitude for this conference and what this all have brought. And I can say, I agree with what everybody has said. So I don't have so much, just to feel this power of diversity in this group. And I feel that we are on our way to unification here. So thank you for those very, very special 4 days in this conference, and gratitude for you to have established this.
Thank you, Grete.
Christina?
It was really wonderful, I would say, in the sense of the wonder that the seventh ray brings, magic and ceremony and all of the good of Aquarian age. I had the feeling, especially at the end, the last day of the conference, that we have been in a kind of hub, which is actually might be compared with the hub of the wheel with H, but the wheel also with ILL, which, as we know, is a characteristic in Libra, where we are said that the reversal takes place. And this gave me some thoughts about this reversal, because we have seen the whole situation through the many talks and reflections and everything, from the past to the future, but also from the future towards our present and past. And this brings another thought in myself, which is the karma. It's something that we say a lot about it, but it's not easy to define. It's not easy for most of us, and of course of humanity, to see her responsibility and the karma that it has to be. What can I say now? To hold the load of this karma, like Atlas held the globe on his shoulders, meaning that it is in our hands, not ours personally, of course, or our groups, but it's a choice of humanity to go this way or the other way, reorientating herself or delaying the procedure. And this sense of being these 4 days in this hub, in a field of tension, as Alex said, I don't remember exactly who, it was really kind of revealing for me in its potentialities, of course. And I see much hope in this, in a real deep sense of hope, not wishful thinking. This is for now, and I'm really grateful also for all the organizers and initiators of this conference, which came a little bit out of the blue, but on right time. And I like this unexpected somehow evolutions or goings on. And yeah, should I say Philip, Michael, Uta, Anto, she knows why, Kathy, Alex, Dennis, Malvin, Jonathan. I don't know, I really want to say the names, like it means something, bringing something in connection. Thank you.
Thank you, Christine. This Libra, polar opposite of air, is the hub of the wheel. You wait as Shambhava, DK tells us as well. We have five minutes left. Well, someone
I'm not sure. Yes, can you hear me?
Go ahead, Katrin.
Yep. It's interesting because the a long time ago, Philip, you were giving the presentation in 2025 initiative. I think it was the astrological overview of the year. And we were on the axis Aries and Libra. And there also was Leo in that triangle for some reason, which I don't remember. But I remember how you said that we can rely on Leo to soften the destruction or destructive power or whatever, this harsh power side of Aries, and allow to support Libra not to compromise away the essence of the process. So I find it very fortunate for the conference to be in this line of energy, Aries, Libra, and then present Leo, the heart that we're focused on, and Aquarian, Pluto, Aquarius. It's from some conferences, you know, yet you leave being informed. From some conferences, you leave being inspired. From this conference, I think we as a group reached the point of movement, shifting forward, and allowing this space to for different voices to be sound and different views to be shared. So, well, I'm really grateful to all, and well, it is just the beginning, but it was very much needed, and I'm really grateful for us all to. For just filling in this gap that was there, like this kind of covered part, which is uncovered now, and therefore we can move. Thank you.
Thanks, Katrin. We have a few more minutes. If anyone else would like to chime in.
Alex, are you trying to talk? Okay, hold on. Sorry. Okay.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, I will try to fit in the minute that left for this session. Just picking up on what Christina said about the right timing. It's not just Aries at the beginning of this cycle. It's, as I mentioned in the first day, it's where the beginning of the 9-year cycle. And in a way, through this conference as a group, we can align with the hierarchical meditation on the vision, on the plan. And so in a way, through our focused action, we meditating on the plan and we drafting the plan, so to speak, for our work all together and for different small groups that we're affiliated with and for our individual service. So it's not just about now. It's this 9-year cycle that ahead of us.
Excellent reminder of these cycles of the new group of world servers, the 9-year cycle being one of the three. We should get those tables made available to the group at some point. But there's some on my website, and there's other people have them as well in PDF. Worth scrutinizing again, I think, reminding ourselves of the cycle of opportunity, essentially.
And so maybe also we can, our next panel session, dedicate really to this. Maybe, 9 years is a long time. Maybe sharing with each other what is our best vision forward also towards 2025 and in this 9-year cycle.
Nine being the number of initiation, DK tells us.
Yeah, I would say that not only the 9-year cycle, because we are in the 4th year or the 7 years of the Impact Week or the new group of our service, and we are in a system of cycles. So I would say that we can share from different points of view what is the now, the here and now.
Yeah. Very good.
And our inspiring visions for the future. I think we can get inspired from each other if we have glimpses of some vision. How to bring this work forward.
And just a minute, 2025 adds to 9.